NASA successfully landed its Perseverance rover on Mars.
A snapshot from Mars has rocked the scientific world, changing the way we think about the red planet.
Something big has just happened on Mars. NASA's rover Perseverance has picked up a mysterious signal that could shake up everything we thought we knew about life out there in the universe. Since launching in 2020, this rover's been roaming the old lakebed at Jezero Crater, hunting for signs that Mars might once have been alive. What if this new signal is the breakthrough we've been hoping for? Let us dive into this thrilling discovery together in crystal clear 4K, Mars Ancient Mysteries. The Mars Perseverance rover is leading NASA's exciting mission to explore Mars, giving us a close look at the planet with its advanced cameras and tools. Launched in July 2020, the rover is investigating the Jezero Crater, a place scientists think might have once held a large lake. This area is especially important because it could help us understand Mars's past and whether it could have supported life long ago. As the Perseverance rover approaches its next site, it captures a mysterious signal that could redefine our search for life beyond Earth. The rover is equipped with some of the most advanced tools, including several cameras and sensors that capture incredibly detailed pictures of Mars. One of these is the Mastcam Z, a powerful camera system that can zoom in and study far-off parts of the Martian landscape with amazing precision. Another important tool is the Watson camera, located on the rover's arm, which takes close-up images of rocks to help scientists decide which ones to collect and study. These high-tech cameras have been key in revealing new details about Mars's surface, like ancient riverbeds and places that might have once been home to life. But the images from Perseverance do more than just help scientists. They also captivate people around the world, allowing them to experience the wonders of space from their own homes. These pictures bring the distant idea of space exploration to life, making it feel more real and exciting. As we move into the year 2024, the Perseverance rover has successfully completed its main tasks and is now beginning what NASA calls an extra mission. In this new phase, Perseverance will face the challenging job of climbing the edge of Jezero Crater on Mars. This climb is expected to uncover ancient rock formations that could provide valuable clues about what conditions were like on Mars a long time ago. Scientists are especially interested in rocks that show signs of having been near water, as these could offer hints about whether life could have ever existed on the red planet. Looking ahead, the main goal of this mission is to help pave the way for future astronauts to visit Mars. The data collected by Perseverance will be vital in deciding where astronauts might land, and in creating the technology needed to keep people alive on Mars. NASA's plan for exploring Mars from 2024 to 2044 involves a series of robotic missions to get ready for human exploration. These missions will focus on important tasks like using materials found on Mars to produce essential resources, such as oxygen and fuel, which are needed to support longer stays on the planet. NASA has made it a priority to keep people engaged and informed throughout the Perseverance rover's journey on Mars. They've done this by sharing clear and detailed pictures and videos, like an amazing 360-degree view of the area where the rover landed. These efforts aim to both teach and excite, bringing the adventure of exploring Mars into homes and classrooms everywhere. Perseverance continues. The work started by an earlier rover, Curiosity, and represents a big step forward in what we know about Mars. The information and materials collected by this rover will keep scientists busy for many years, helping them piece together the planet's weather history and see if it could have supported life long ago. This mission is not just about exploring another planet. It's about pushing the boundaries of what humans can do in space. Let's see how Mars might be our next home through NASA's eyes. The next frontier in human endeavor. Simply put, NASA's Perseverance rover is crucial in our study of Mars, offering valuable insights into the planet's past, its present, and its potential to support life in the future. Every photo and sample the rover sends back brings us closer to answering a big question that has fascinated people for a long time. Are we alone in the universe? But that's not all. The mission has faced many challenges along the way, and there are still many more questions to answer. Thinking about living on Mars is pretty exciting, isn't it? At first, it sounds like a thrilling adventure, but when you dig a bit deeper, it's actually one of the most complex, risky, and expensive projects humans have ever dreamed up. Imagine trying to build ancient Rome, launch the Apollo 11 mission, set up the International Space Station, and explore the American frontier, all at the same time. Now picture doing all of that 150 million miles away, on a cold and empty desert planet. To make Mars our new home, we need a level of teamwork like never before in space exploration. Imagine NASA, with all its history and experience, joining forces with SpaceX, a company known for its daring ideas and innovation. Together, they're breaking down barriers and pushing to turn humanity into a species that can live on more than one planet. Elon Musk often talks about a unique moment in time. For over 3 billion years, life has existed on Earth, but only now, in our lifetimes, have we created the technology needed to leave our planet and set foot on another. This moment is special, and it comes with a big responsibility. For the first time in billions of years, we have a chance to do this, but who knows how long that chance will last. If everything goes well, Earth might stay livable for another billion years. But in the worst case, things could change suddenly, even today. This sense of urgency is what drives us to keep exploring and pushing limits. It's in our nature to seek new frontiers and survive. Now we just need the means to get there. This idea is what inspired Elon Musk to start SpaceX about 20 years ago. We have the drive to explore, and SpaceX aims to make it possible. Their vision led to the creation of the Starship Super Heavy rocket, the first rocket designed to handle the tough challenges of deep space travel. But space exploration isn't a one-person job. It means moving a lot of supplies and equipment, and that requires a lot of power. So far, the most powerful rockets ever launched from Earth were NASA's Saturn V in the 1960s and their Space Launch System in November 2022. Both rockets were built to send people beyond our planet. The Saturn V could carry 50 metric tons to the moon, which was enough for 3 astronauts to visit and return after a week. But what would it take to support 10 astronauts on a mission to Mars that could last 2 years? But that's not even the toughest part. The Starship's Super Heavy booster now creates more than double the thrust of the old Saturn V, marking a huge jump in rocket technology. And we're only at the stage of testing the first prototypes. SpaceX is already working on a third version of their Raptor engine, which could bring even more improvements. Next, we face the huge challenges and big dreams of reaching Mars. The Starship Odyssey. The plan starts with getting 100 metric tons to Mars, but the final Starship design might be able to carry up to 150 metric tons. That's a big increase. But if we look back at the Apollo missions, it's clear that going to Mars will need much more than just tripling our current capabilities. The challenge ahead is enormous, but so are our dreams of exploring the stars. But wait, there's more to think about. Moving people and supplies to Mars is just one part of the puzzle. We also need to figure out how to keep them safe, healthy, and productive on a planet that's nothing like Earth. The big idea behind Starship isn't just about having a powerful rocket. It's about doing things differently by using numbers to our advantage. Between 1966 and 1973, NASA built 15 Saturn V rockets, successfully launching 13 of them and sent 24 astronauts to the moon. But Starship is aiming to go far beyond that. The plan isn't just to launch a single Starship, it's to launch many. SpaceX has set an ambitious goal of building one Starship every day to meet these high expectations. Elon Musk has talked about a future with 1,000 Starships traveling back and forth between Earth and Mars. In 2022, there were 180 rocket launches worldwide, but Musk envisions his fleet of Starships launching over 5 times that number. Each Starship could carry 10 to 100 times the weight of today's rockets. Musk's ultimate goal is to move up to 1 million metric tons of supplies to Mars, which he believes would be enough to build a self-sustaining city, completely independent of Earth. But this isn't the end of the story. Starship, despite all its strengths, isn't enough on its own to set up a colony on Mars. Its design has some major gaps that mean it can't reach its goals without learning from the successes and failures of past space missions. Just as Luke Skywalker needed Yoda's wisdom, SpaceX will need to rely on older aerospace technologies to make human travel to Mars sustainable. Elon Musk's strategy with his companies, like SpaceX and Tesla, has always been about taking action. Instead of waiting for perfect technology, they use what's available and make it better. You can see this approach in how Tesla introduced a fully electric sports car in 2008, a time when most people didn't think it was possible. And yet, they made it work. However, there's a challenge. Starship depends on chemical propulsion, a technology that combines highly flammable fuel with liquid oxygen and ignites them under pressure to create thrust. This method has been around since the 1960s, and even though there have been many improvements, the limits set by physics suggest we might be reaching the maximum potential of chemical rockets. Elon Musk himself has mentioned that the Raptor engine, which powers the Starship, has achieved a combustion efficiency of 99.99%, meaning there's not much room left for improvement. Only a higher power could make those molecules break apart better. Even with all the advanced technology SpaceX uses, like tinkering with turbo pumps and trying to increase chamber pressure, they still can't increase the thrust by 5 times. The laws of physics just don't allow it with the rockets we have today. Now let's tackle the tough barriers to living on Mars. Pioneering the nuclear path to Mars. This limitation might not seem like a big deal for most missions, but think about a spacecraft traveling from Earth to Mars. What if that ship could travel 5 times faster through space? A journey that currently takes 8 months could be reduced to just 45 days. This isn't just a nice idea. It's crucial for any serious plan to build a community on Mars. Right now, SpaceX's Starship doesn't meet these speed requirements. It's simply too slow. And that's the reality. No adjustments or upgrades we have now can make it much faster. To make colonizing Mars possible, we need a huge leap in space travel technology. Without that breakthrough, our dreams of living on Mars will stay out of reach, held back by the slow pace at which we can travel across the vast distance between Earth and Mars. But this isn't the worst part. Even with all our current efforts, the speed gap is just one of many challenges we face in making life on Mars a reality. NASA is introducing a new technique called nuclear thermal propulsion, which is a type of rocket engine powered by nuclear energy. This new approach allows SpaceX to increase the power of their Starship by 5 times. At the heart of the system is a small fission reactor that works by splitting uranium atoms. When these atoms split, they release a lot of heat energy. To turn this heat into movement, liquid hydrogen is sent into the reactor. The extreme heat quickly turns the liquid into gas, and this gas is then pushed out through the engine's nozzle, propelling the rocket forward. It's like how a steam engine works, but instead of on Earth, it's happening in the vastness of space. This nuclear method is much more powerful than the usual chemical rocket engines used in space. It opens up new possibilities for space exploration, making trips to faraway planets faster and more efficient. This propulsion system doesn't just increase speed, it changes the way we think about traveling beyond Earth, bringing the idea of exploring the universe a little closer to reality. The newest rocket design is expected to make space travel much more efficient, with performance improving by 3 to 5 times. This means future spacecraft could travel faster, carry more cargo, and explore farther into space. They would also be able to move around in space more easily and quickly than any rockets we've used before. This rocket engine idea isn't brand new. NASA has been exploring this technology off and on for many years, starting with some early experiments back in the 1960s. However, after those initial efforts, progress slowed down, and the development of this technology was paused for a long time. Recently, though, NASA has renewed its interest in this technology with a new project called DRACO, which focuses on developing a nuclear thermal rocket engine. They have set an ambitious goal to launch their first nuclear-powered spacecraft within the next 5 years. While this is a tight timeline, and building a new spacecraft in such a short period is challenging, the goal of creating the nuclear engine itself is more within reach. For companies like SpaceX, working with nuclear materials for rocket experiments comes with many regulatory and logistical challenges. But it also presents exciting possibilities for improving space travel. By using nuclear power, these rockets could greatly boost their abilities, making space exploration more efficient and allowing us to travel farther than ever before. Next up, we deal with the tough rules and new tech needed for Mars. Mars and nuclear horizons. But this isn't the most difficult part. Beyond the technical challenges, there are other hurdles that need to be overcome. Regulating technology is important, but it can make developing new tech very expensive for private companies. This is where government agencies have an edge. Take NASA, for example. If they provided an engine and SpaceX contributed a spacecraft, they could team up effectively. Together, they could create a nuclear-powered spacecraft, which would be ideal for trips between Earth and Mars. Nuclear power has even more potential than just powering engines in space. It could also provide the energy needed for human settlements on Mars. Solar energy might not be enough on Mars, especially until we can build large solar farms on another planet. But nuclear power offers a promising alternative. NASA's Kilopower project, for instance, is a small nuclear reactor designed for this exact situation. It could provide steady and significant energy from the start, which is crucial for keeping a Martian colony running smoothly. NASA plans to launch a 10-kilowatt reactor on the Moon by the end of this decade. This is an important move toward establishing human settlements on both the Moon and Mars. Even though NASA is an older organization, it's clear they are still making valuable contributions, particularly in nuclear technology. Along with power generation, NASA is also highly skilled in logistics, which is crucial for setting up colonies in space. On the other hand, Elon Musk often talks about building a city on Mars, but he hasn't shared many details about how it will actually work. Important questions like how to build it, who will go, and how it will be managed are still unanswered. Managing a space colony is a big deal, and Musk's challenges with running a social media platform like Twitter raise concerns. If he handles a Martian colony the same way, the consequences could be serious. But NASA is already tackling these issues head-on. For example, they have created a prototype of a Martian habitat called Mars Dune Alpha, which was made using 3D printing technology. This habitat could eventually be used on Mars. Right now, NASA is running experiments where a team lives in a simulated Mars environment to see how humans might adapt to living there for a long time. This hands-on approach to solving problems in tough conditions shows that NASA is well prepared and capable of handling the challenges of space colonization. Yet, the journey isn't without its hurdles. NASA's focus on the nitty-gritty details of logistics and habitat design highlights their commitment to getting it right. But challenges are always around the corner. Will these preparations be enough to truly pave the way for a sustainable human presence on Mars? That remains to be seen. For a whole year now, a team has been living inside a simulation of a space colony. We're watching how they deal with the isolation and the challenges that come with living in this kind of environment. Doing this research is really important before we think about sending astronauts far into space. NASA's long experience and deep knowledge are incredibly valuable here. They've been studying Mars up close for many years and have unmatched expertise in running long missions on its surface. While the idea of a single daring billionaire setting up a Mars colony on their own might sound thrilling, it's more likely to end in disaster. The partnership between SpaceX and NASA is crucial. They rely on each other. Working together, they improve their chances of making human life on Mars a reality. What do you think? Can private companies alone make Mars colonization safe? Like, comment, and subscribe for more.